Just about summer already. The days are hot, the afternoons rainy and stormy, and that's the perfect recipe for algae in our water.
Yeah, a lot of us are wondering if we're in for another disastrous summer season. So we sent NBC2's Jacqueline Beavis to test the waters of Lee County to try and find out.
This is one spot in Alva last year that saw a lot of blue-green algae collecting in the Caloosahatchee here, so we thought it'd be a good first spot to grab a sample.
With the help of the FGCU Water School, we took four samples from the Caloosahatchee River.
We're here in Cape Coral now, and this is a canal that actually did have some issues last year, so we're going to see how it's testing early this year.
Taking each sample to FGCU's Dr. Serge Thomas, who takes a closer look.
I mean, definitely they are here.
Checking under the microscope to see if we find blue-green algae.
Uh-oh. Same stuff. Microcystis.
Now we're near the Tarpon Street Pier. This area has tested positive already, so we're going to see how it tests now.
Yeah, I don't see anything that's really too concerning.
For each sample, Dr. Thomas filtered the water.
It's a green, right? You can see how green it is compared to the other samples.
Looking at a more concentrated version of our samples.
And then we're going to collect the good stuff on the bottom.
And narrowing them down to just drops under the microscope.
It's there. And definitely in Alva, we do have conditions that eventually the conditions are right. You know, those guys could thrive and just come back to the surface.
Our sample near Alva positive for cyanobacteria, but no algal bloom yet.
It looks like it's suspended on the water right now.
And more good news, no major finds of blue-green algae in North Fort Myers, Cape Coral, or near the Tarpon Street Pier in Fort Myers.
What we're not sure is what's going to be the rainy season this year, you know, but if we have the conditions that are nutrients and light and warm water, that's what will favor cyanobacteria.
Hopefully that won't be quite as bad this year.
So we went to NBC2 First Alert meteorologist Rob Duns to see how much rain we've got in this year.
But it's not nearly as pronounced as last year.
Above average, but much better than 2018.
More often than not, when we have El Nino years, there's less tropical weather activity. And that bodes well. Obviously, if we don't get as many tropical systems here, it could, you know, cut back on the amount of rainfall.
Keeping rain totals low keeps watershed lower as well. That moves fewer nutrients from Lake O and our own backyards into our rivers and canals.
Regardless of what big weather features may impact the weather forecast, it's going to rain a lot more for us in June and July just because of our climate. It's been warm for the month of April. It looks to be warm for the month of May. And, you know, warm weather is going to help out algae growth, obviously.
The kind of climate that blue-green algae loves is standard in the Sunshine State.
We could predict them, you know, we would be ahead of the game, right? And for now, we can't really predict them.
And with no real way to predict what's in store, we can only hope that this summer is better than last.
We have more and more and more of those recurring algae, and that's us, you know, we are the problem.
Similar to red tide, blue-green algae can be around in the water without being overly active. When you see those clumps like we did last year, that's when you know it's a full bloom. Concerns of toxicity levels rise then as well. Now, there's a lot that scientists have left to do on the research end. So as for this year, many of our questions will be answered in time. Reporting along the Caloosahatchee River, Jacqueline Beavis, NBC.